Hello, I'm Dr. Althea Need Kaminske. In this video, I'm going to go over the research on how to take notes in class. Something to keep in mind while we talk about the best way to take notes is the goal of note-taking. Note-taking does two important things. First, note-taking helps you encode information. It forces you to process the information in order to put it into whatever form your notes take. That processing helps with memory and understanding. Second, notes are a kind of external storage. You can use them to help you review and remember the information later on. So how should you take notes? One of the biggest questions I see on note-taking is whether you should take notes by hand or by typing. The research on this shows that it depends on how you are using your notes. So for the purposes of this video, let's assume that you are taking your notes in class so that you can review them later on when you are studying outside of class and potentially again right before a quiz or a test. So you won't be expected to remember the information immediately after taking the notes, and you will have a chance to review your notes before any sort of test. Initially, research pointed towards an advantage for taking notes by hand over typing. Researchers found that students who took notes by typing had more complete notes. In other words, their notes were closer to a transcription of the lecture they watched. But students who took notes by hand remembered more. This seems a little counterintuitive. Why aren't more complete notes better? Researchers theorized that it has to do with the encoding or the processing that you are forced to do when you take notes by hand. It's easier and faster to type, so students tried to make an accurate transcription of the lecture. But when you take notes by hand, you're a bit limited. This limitation forces you to figure out what the most important information is and write that down. It forces you to do an extra bit of processing. And that extra bit of processing is what's beneficial for later memory and understanding of the notes that you took. So should you take notes by hand and avoid typing your notes altogether? Not necessarily. Other researchers found that the advantage of taking notes by hand versus typing was very small or went away entirely if students were able to review their notes before being tested. So typing your notes can be effective if you review them later. Of course, there's a lot more to note-taking than how they are written. Whether you are typing your notes or writing them by hand, what should you be writing down? There are lots of different note-taking systems out there. I won't be reviewing all of the different systems here because in the end, I think that almost any system of note-taking is better than no system at all. What is important is that you take notes in a way that helps you encode or process information, organize it in a way that helps you find what you need later, and allows you to easily add pictures or diagrams. As an example, I'll go over the Cornell note-taking method and highlight how it helps you encode, organize, and add drawings. In the Cornell note-taking method, you divide your paper into three sections. I'm giving an example of how you could do that by hand, but it's easy enough to add lines and columns to typed notes as well. The right-hand section of the paper is for real-time note-taking. Here is where you write notes during class, trying to capture the main points and details. The left-hand section is for writing cues, main ideas from the lecture or class as a whole, prompts and questions, things like that. These cues are meant to be short, but more big picture. You should fill this section in after class. The bottom is for writing a summary of the notes. Here, you can summarize the notes in your own words to help you connect the information together. I like this system because it has reviewing your notes built into it. Your notes are complete until you've taken the time to reflect on them and jot down the big ideas. I also like that the simple trick of drawing some lines on the page helps you organize your notes. This organization forces you to think about the information as you're writing it down, the encoding part we've talked about, and it helps you find the information later. The cue section is really useful when you need to look through your notes for a specific piece of information. Finally, it's easy to add drawings and diagrams into these notes. Drawings and diagrams are important because they give you another way to understand the information, making use of what is known as dual coding. Dual coding simply refers to the finding that it is easier for us to process and remember information if it is presented both visually and verbally. For example, imagine studying an anatomy and physiology textbook without any pictures. it would be really difficult to understand how structures fit together if you don't have any visual reference. On the other hand, imagine an anatomy and physiology textbook without any words. You would still have a lot of interesting pictures, but you might have some trouble following along without any explanation of what you're looking at. You don't need to be an artist in order to make dual coding work for you. Even if your pictures aren't perfect, they can still help you organize and think about the information. For example, if I was taking notes on the structure of the brain, this is what my drawings might look like. They are far from perfect, but they help me understand where the different areas of the brain are in relation to one another and what those areas do. So what do you need to know about note-taking? Well, first, whether you're taking notes by hand or typing, what is important is that you take notes in a way that helps you process information and in a way that helps you organize it so that you can review it later. And, when you can, add pictures and diagrams to help you make sense of the information. For more about the research behind note-taking, I've provided some references and links in the description below. Thanks for watching.